What's going on, everybody? Got another airsoft gun, and this one's a pretty cool one. Obviously it came with a lot of stuff because I got it used on eBay, which is what I love doing because you get extras. So clearly I've already used the knee pads in game and a lot of that bag. So it is a Echo 1 XCR OEM'd by VFC, which means it's the better one. So this is not a review, this is just me saying that I got the gun and I want to show it off to you guys. I already used it in gameplay, so right after this video I should be finishing up the gameplay. I didn't get many kills, I only got like one kill with it really, but just for the sake of it I recorded it. So what it came with clearly was the box itself, some Condor D-pads, two packs of KOA Perfect 0.20 grams, which I do not like at all because 20 grams don't fly very far at all. That's actually the reason I did so bad this weekend. And some 30 grams Mabel and a wall charger, which clearly I don't need. So it's either licensed by ISGK or by Echo One, but it is made by VFC, so it's got a VFC gearbox and externals, meaning they are excellent. And this gun truly shoots very well. The gearbox sounds beautiful, and it is a very, very solid gun. The whole thing is super duper solid. So it also came with this orange flash hider made out of plastic, but it did come with a steel one, which is currently on the gun. It also came with another speed loader, since I already have one, but this one is kind of weird. It doesn't work all the time, and it is chipped, but it is just a cheap speed loader anyway. Came with this magazine. It is just a mid cap. It looks like the way VFC puts those little bumps, which are kind of bad. You can't really use them in other guns, but it feeds decently well. And obviously the box itself is really nice because of all the foam. So the battery it came with, I assume, is a 9.6. I barely took a glimpse at it when I took the pack apart. It was kind of confusing, so I just charge it inside the pec box. So here's the gun, the Echo 1 XCR. Very solid gun. Very small as well, smaller than I thought it would be. And the way you know it's the VFC model is because the stock is kind of skeletonized and with this foam pad on it, which I like. And yeah, it's a very nice gun. Very solid. The licensing for it says Robinson Armament. And yeah, the low receiver is all metal. Everything is pretty much metal, what you would expect to be. It's got a charging handle on it, so you can just hop up and everything. And then pretty much like Masada style bolt release. Pretty cool. I love the angle of the selector switch. Very nice. And the trigger, pretty short. Downside of this gun is that it'll still fire on semi. It's probably a malfunction with this model. I don't know what's up with that, but otherwise it is in perfect condition. It fires just fine, and that whole semi-auto thing, not a big issue if you have trigger discipline. So it came with a foregrip as well. I assume that comes with the original packaging. Here's a look at the pec box that it came with, just to hold the battery. Got quad rails. Here's a look at the steel flash hider that came with it. Pretty nice. Has no iron sights, so I want to pick up some M buses for it. It says XCR on the side. I think it's laser engraved into the metal, so very nice. Echo 1 on the trigger guard. I like how they placed it there, very cool. and I really like the stock. You'll see that the other XCRs have an M4 stock, and those XCRs are the cheaper, I think, Echo 1 versions, because they were built by Echo 1 or whoever, but not VFC. This is the VFC one. It's so much nicer. Alright, so I'm gonna plug it in and do a little shooting. Just wanted to show everything it came with before the gameplay and the review, just let everyone know that it is here and it is cool. It's got a folding stock too. Very, very compact, very small gun. I very much like it. It's very cool. So now that I've announced this gun, I can announce all the upcoming videos. There's gonna be gameplay on this, gameplay on the beta project, a review of both of those AAGs, so these videos are gonna take place over a long amount of time. But now that I'm finishing high school, I'll have plenty of time to make those reviews. And possibly a cinematic review just like the 5.7, only with the KWA MP7 from the Zodiac. And a traditional, long, detailed review of the 5.7 if anybody's interested. That'll also be a thing that'll be coming out. So this is going to be a very busy summer for me here at Six Echelon, and I'm going to be looking into making movies and videos and all kinds of interesting stuff. So look forward to it, and subscribe so you don't miss out on any of this cool airsoft stuff that's going on.